What's going on, guys? Have we got some Bleach news for you? Today, we have been blessed with two pieces of information, which I think you guys are particularly going to like. However, I do feel like they're small, so if you like these type of videos where it's a small kind of update or a big update, please let me know in the comment section down below. Please hit the like and comment and hit the subscribe too, because it does actually help me out. But with that being said, we have some anime production information, which again, we can discuss and escalate and kind of get our thinking caps going on of what's actually popping off. So first and foremost, Kubo has said, "I'm checking out the anime. It's been a long time since I've done an anime, so I'm having to redo the character charts for all the main characters. My drawing style has changed a bit since the last chapter, so I'm making some minor adjustments to make it fit my current feeling. But it's fun." And correct me if I'm wrong, that Kubo is essentially taking the role of a character designer. Now, of course, if you know, the previous Bleach anime was character designed by Musashi Kudo. And as of currently, my belief on this, I don't think Musashi Kudo is currently involved as a character designer. And that's not a bad thing, to be honest with you. I personally would like a fresh new main team, which means not Noriaki Ebe directing the series, nor having Musashi Kudo as the character designer. Again, I'm not against either of those, but by the seams of things, it seems that Noriaki Ebe is still busy on other projects, as well as Musashi Kudo seems to be working with Sega and some other series at the moment. So, you know, as it stands, I'm not convinced. However, I personally would like a fresh new team to give Bleach a fresh new feel and direction as well. And with the amount of different directors out there working on anime, I can say that, to be honest, I think we can have a lot better, to be honest. But I mean, maybe that's a shit take. I don't know. Depends on how you guys feel. I know you guys don't like change very much. However, now this is interesting because I actually generally questioned whether we were going to have a character designer. And it seems to be that, yeah, probably we will. Like 95% of the time, we are going to have a character designer, probably for minor characters. But for the main characters, which Kubo does specifically say he's going to be doing new character charts, which is genuinely talking about new character sheets, such as like your character profiles, your fronts, your sides and your backs, and the minor little trinkets that they have as well, which again is cool for the main cast. Well, depending what the main cast is, I assume it's the majority of characters that are going to have the most screen time. Obviously Ichigo and his crew, the captains and some Soul Reapers, as well as possibly some of the Sternritters as well, which is really cool because, again, I like Musashi Kudo. I personally think his character designs are a little bit feminine, but, you know, having Kubo on board is not a bad thing either, because Kubo usually draws very detailed. So I know a lot of complaints with Burn the Witch is that there wasn't enough detail within Kubo's style, and, you know, I would agree. You know, it's not personally my design choice that I would have chose personally. I prefer BBS's kind of character designs in that regard. However, it was still cool nonetheless. But it seems that if Kubo is going to be doing the character designs for the anime, we can expect some really high detailed drawings, which the key animators and in-betweeners are going to have probably a hard time doing. But I am believing in the process nonetheless. So that's really cool that he's going to get himself involved within the anime to that extent. Again, character designing, you know, it could be a one-stop deal. However, we have some more information, which is really cool as well, because he also wrote that, "I'm going to check the animation storyboards. I don't get to see storyboards very often, so it's refreshing." Now, storyboards in regards to this is, well, he said multiple storyboards, because that's what storyboards are, not a storyboard. It seems that, you know, there is probably a good amount of episodes which have storyboards, which is very interesting, because there could be 24 episodes of Bleach right there being storyboarded that we just haven't seen yet. And that's kind of worrying, but also exciting at the same time, because I hope that they're cool. I hope that the direction's great as well. And again, if Kubo is supervising or checking up on these storyboards or is involved in the process of creating them, then even better, because his direction of how action scenes go are so cool. Especially if you've read Bleach, you know that some of his directions are kind of intense and kind of stylistic as well. So I'm very excited to see that. And it is, you know, it's not a common trait for manga artists to get involved to this extent, where they're doing their own character designs as well as getting involved in their own storyboards as well. So usually when it comes to storyboards, directors will be the ones that are dealing with the storyboarding and how things are going to be paced out. So usually after the director's done with the storyboards, he usually then sends it out to the layout team, and then the layout team puts it in a widescreen format. Then it goes on to the key animators, and then it goes into the in-betweeners, etc., etc. So we're in very close territory entries to actually getting onto the animation sides of things, because now we've gotten into the storyboard side of things, which is cool. However, to have the manga artist actually get involved with the storyboarding is, again, a very rare instance, and it goes to show how much Kubo is getting involved with this project. And I can't wait to see what else he gets involved with later on. But the fact that he's getting involved within the storyboard may actually give us some maybe extra scenes that we didn't get in the manga, some things that he intended to in the first place, or things that maybe he wanted to change a little, or maybe add a little, or maybe just completely give a different environment to. So that is very exciting, because again, we're getting Kubo's vision, and that was the most important aspect of the Bleach manga, was having Kubo's vision. As we all know, that Kubo had some health issues as well as some rushness towards the end of the manga as well. So that is very, very cool. And especially if he is getting involved in extra content as well, it would be placed where Kubo wanted it as well. So again, having a director have his storyboards checked by the actual manga artist is, again, very rare. Most directors usually just do the storyboards and send it off, but it seems like the storyboards are having revisions, they are having quality control checks as well. So again, very fascinating. I guess I do want to also bring up as well, seeing as Kubo is going to be on the character design list of things, I feel I do also have to mention the fact that he says he's redoing these character designs goes to tell me that there is going to be an inconsistency, of course, with the old anime and the new anime. Of course, we kind of all kind of got that. However, you know, we're going to see, you know, different Ichigo and his gang in like newer quality animation, newer quality resolutions. And that was going to be usually the only difference. However, the fact that he's redoing the character sheets goes kind of to tell me that, to what extent, you know, is it going to be Thousand Year Blood War Ichigo and beyond, or is he going to be tapping into older designs as well? The fact that he says he's redoing them, I mean, you know, you could ask the question of, oh, well, why can't we use Masashi Kudo's sheets from like the Fullbringer arc, right? Because there is, you know, a similarity of quite how Kubo's style was back then. But the fact that he's going in with a fresh approach and a new approach at that goes maybe to ask the question of, how is Bleach going to, you know, start off? How is it going to display itself? And I feel like that's the most important question, since as, you know, many new fans and many old fans are going to see this for the first time, and whether we're engaged or not is, you know, a deal breaker in a sense. You know, if that first episode doesn't hit correctly, you know, it could be a make or break. And it is interesting because there is a lot of flashbacks in Bleach in regards to the old series, a lot of revelations, especially within White Ichigo and Yu Habaki. You are going to get a lot of, you know, what happened back in the day. So does this kind of clarify our remake of the anime situation here? Are we going to get a few episodes where it's going to be rehashing or remaking some of the old arcs to implement it and lead up to the Thousand Year Blood War arc? We really don't know, but the fact that he is redoing some old character designs means that, you know, he wants to keep it consistent, so when we do have a flashback, or even if we do have a remake, it's all going to flow in quite nicely, and there isn't going to be some like drastic change to which, you know, most long running anime have been used to back in the past. So again, are we going to discuss the compilation films? Are we going to discuss a few episodes of recap? It could be possibly the case, especially for storyboarding, and if Kubo's getting involved in the storyboarding, it's very important to make sure those storyboards are impactful and they hit, because again, the viewer, a new viewer watching it, is going to be either sold or he's going to be not, you know. So I'm very excited. These two pieces of news are very interesting, and again, we are getting closer and closer to the actual like animation side of things, and literally we are on the bare bones of the start of production. Now granted, the storyboards have been done, so actually we are should be moving into the layout stage very shortly. So again, we could be into the animation side of things maybe late December going into January, because again, it's a long series, there's probably a lot of storyboarding to do, and again, things seem to be going quite a good speed at the moment. Again, Shueisha, I hope you are putting in a lot of pennies towards this. Kubo seems to be very dedicated. He's been a very busy man by the seams of it, with the expo, with the new logo that we're going to be getting, with the character designs, with the storyboarding, and probably much, much more later on, as well as keeping content for his Club Kubo as well. So again, a lot of things going on. If there is the storyboarding phase, it means that the opening has been storyboarded too, potentially. And it probably means that we also do have a band as well. So I hope that opening really slaps as well, which I'm excited for. Other than that, do I still believe we're going to get a key visual at Jump Festa? I hope so. It seems like we are going in that direction to get a key visual. That's my personal opinion, not a fact. However, depending on how this key visual is going to look is depending on, you know, we will find out if Kubo has been the one to do these character designs in this key visual, which is also exciting as well. Because again, I was kind of hesitant. Are we going to get like a character designer that doesn't draw Bleach that well? Or are we going to get a good one? And that kind of has shifted for me to have a bit more confidence within the key visual, because if it's anything by Kubo's designs, it's going to be really high detailed. There's going to be a lot of lines within the drawing. So I'm very excited, yet kind of worried still at the same time. Because obviously, you can't be 100% you know, sure about if you're going to like something subjectively. So fingers crossed, I'm more optimistic than I was, which is great. And again, we're going to see his involvement in regarding that as well. But anyway, I hope you like this quick little update. Again, tell me if you like these quick little updates and if you want me to carry on doing them. Other than that, I'm going to catch you guys later. Please hit that subscribe button. Again, it helps me out so much, you guys don't understand. And I would like to get to 100,000 by the end of next year, or by the time that the first Bleach episode comes out, because that would be really awesome. Other than that, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, as always, people. Peace out.